Draw me a picture and tell me where you are. I'll picture where you are and right back.
What about Maria?
Who knows? I think that she and Max spent the night together. Thank you so much for this, Max. Really, I should have never doubted you.
No problem. So, are you ready?
I've been thinking about this my whole life. I am so ready.
Let's go. Houston, I just missed my connecting flight.
It's okay.
No, it's not. I'm really sorry.
It's fine.
Look, do me a favor. Don't just sit at home alone. Okay, go out, have a good time, enjoy the night for both of us.
I don't know.
But please, Isabel. It's bad enough I'm gonna be stuck in an airport. I don't want you to have a crappy New Year's, too. Please.
Okay. This isn't fair. I'm really sorry, Petunia. But in about 3 minutes, I'm out of here. You're never gonna find it. Oh, please. This year, I'm gonna find it. Trust me.
Find what? Enigma?
You know about Enigma?
Well, I lived here all my life. That secret New Year's Eve party has been going on since before I was your age.
Well, did you ever find it?
Once. Did you dish up the tapioca?
50 times. Dad.
Daughter.
Come on. I don't really need me to be doing this.
Liz, you and I have done this party together since you were, like, this high. It's a family tradition.
What, that I went on a bunch of geriatrics for all eternity?
I tell you what. When you're finally a resident of the Desert End Retirement Community, then you don't have to come here for New Year's Eve.
Gee, thanks. Petunia.
Work on him. I have a feeling he'll weaken. Otherwise, I'll tell you about Enigma tomorrow morning. Bye! Sorry.
So Enigma, huh?
Yep. And no, I don't think it's lame or stupid or any of the other 50 insults you're about to spew out.
I wasn't gonna spew, just talking.
So what are you doing tonight?
I don't know. TV, PlayStation, something.
Alone?
Yep.
What about Max? Why don't you two go, I don't know, look for a party or something?
Oh yeah, he's the original party animal. I'd rather surf the tube. Have fun.
Hey, wait. You want to come find Enigma with me?
Wouldn't that violate the whole we're not dating anymore thing?
It's not a date. It's a scavenger hunt looking for party clues, and two heads are better than one. No midnight kiss, no pawing in the backseat. We just find the party and then go our separate ways till dawn. Deal?
Deal. Thank you. Now that my immortal soul's been cleansed, on to more terrestrial concerns. It's been a dry couple of years. Kyle needs a woman. Kyle needs her badly. Kyle needs her tonight. Well, thank you. But if that's a Jehovah's Witness, I'm coming back here.
Hi.
Hey.
Kyle Valenti, it is your lucky night.
Shiny New Year! No?
No, I can't. I'm going out.
On New Year's Eve?
Yeah, imagine that. I'm going to that Enigma thing.
Really? Do you know where it is?
No, but I'm gonna find out.
Hmm. Or you could save yourself the aggravation and buddy up here with Rudolph and his shiny New Year. Oh, and I brought goobers.
Tempting, but no.
Jesse missed his flight and is stuck in Houston. I had this whole romantic evening planned and I had to scrap it.
Boo-hoo!
Kyle, it's Enigma.
Yeah, it's just sex, drugs, and whatever's passing for rock and roll these days. Why would I want to go there?
Okay, fine. Well, do you mind if an old married lady tags along?
Okay. But I'm warning you, I'm a man on a mission, sex or death, so don't get in my way and don't cramp my style.
You have style?
Hey.
Okay, let's go. Where's the first clue?
At the high school, Mr. Seligman's room.
Oh, right.
Bring the goobers, I'm driving.
I'm sorry.
It's all right. I had a feeling he wasn't gonna let you get off work.
So what are you gonna do?
Go back to Michael's and avoid New Year's Rockin' Eve.
Why don't you just go out with Maria and Michael?
To Enigma?
Uh-huh.
I'm not really the party guy. I'm just more of a one-on-one guy.
No, seriously. When was the last time that you went out and had fun at a party with people you didn't know?
I don't know.
Exactly. Come on. There's no reason both of us should have a crummy New Year's.
I'd feel like a third wheel.
No, you would be a guy hanging out with his two best friends on New Year's, and you'd be having a really good time.
I need more convincing. I almost believe it.
Goodbye. I have to go back downstairs.
All right, okay. But on one condition. Midnight comes and we're together.
How are we gonna do that? I'm gonna be downstairs and you are gonna be
out. We find a way. Somehow, some way we make it happen. Liz.
Okay. I'll find a way.
Okay. See you at midnight.
We met a couple of months ago. Remember the movie thing?
Oh, yes, I do. Hi, how are you?
Oh, out the pasture. But I'm doing just fine now. How are you?
I'm okay.
Who's the Guy Lombardo over there?
That's Jim Valenti and his band, the Kit Shookers.
Did you just say...
No. It's the Kit Shookers. It sounds bad, but it isn't.
Mm-hmm. Well, I sure hope those bastards can play.
Hi. How about a compromise? I will stay for the party, but then once we've done the whole stupid pretend it's midnight at 10:30 thing, I'm out of here, okay?
First of all, when you're 80 and you want to be in bed by 11, you might not think it's so stupid. Second of all, I'm not going to get stuck with doing all the cleanup myself.
Ugh.
And third, I don't want you and Max catting around the desert all night.
Catting around?
Sweetie, your plans for this evening are set.
Watch. You know, this is wrecking and entering.
Well, we get caught, we'll party in jail.
The girl wants to party.
This is the first clue. Hut, hut, that's football, right? Maybe the party is on the football field.
Yeah, I don't know. That's too easy.
So why are you really here? What are you talking about? I'm looking for Enigma. Did Liz put you up to this? Are you chaperoned for me and Maria or something? It's New Year's Eve. I'm looking for a party, okay? Hey, I know how to party.
All right. This is what I gather. It's a quarterback's call, and there's a number 7. Dave Lambert is a number 7.
Who's Dave Lambert?
The star quarterback at Isabel's College. Anyway, so Julia says...
Who's Julia?
That's Julia. Dave Lambert's fraternity is having a party, which is probably where the next clue to Enigma is. So, let's go. Out the window, Garen. Oh, yeah, Max, listen. This chaperone thing, I know that Liz put you up to it, but Michael and I were clear that this is not a date.
I'm not a chaperone. I'm really looking for the party.
Right, okay. And whose car is this?
My boss, Toby's.
And these would be the keys.
What if we get caught?
We won't.
How many blue vipers are there in Roswell?
One.
One. And, I'm sorry, how many people have access to this garage after hours besides your boss?
One.
Yeah, we're gonna get caught.
Maybe. But this thing's a chip magnet, Isabel. I've seen it work. I'll take the risk. Get in.
Oh, man. I'm not really gonna risk taking root. I hope this doesn't cramp your style.
Yellow wasn't my first choice, but that's cool.
You were someplace else.
No, he's not.
Don't shicka shicka.
You're funny.
Boy trouble.
Well, sort of. My parents don't really approve of my boyfriend.
I'm having the same problem.
Really?
You see that crotchety old couple over there? My mom and dad. You'd think they'd leave Frank and me be by now, but no.
Well, which one is Frank?
Oh, he's not here. New Year's means a lot to them. Kind of a sentimental thing, you know? So Frank goes out with his buddies in VFW, and I give them this one night of the year.
But don't you mind being apart on New Year's?
Oh, sure we do, but, well, your parents won't always be there. And besides, we have phone sex at midnight.
Easy clue. See, the hot part meant the falafel hut across the street, and the 24 and the 7 were on either side of the 20, so here we are at the side of the next clue. All right, the car, huh?
Yeah.
Jerky?
No, thanks.
Hey! I can ask you a question from the future. Yes?
Those your teeth lying on the ground?
Bye-bye.
You know, I think I like you.
Yeah, the way you're like a monkey in a little hat. I was just entertainment till the real men showed up.
Is this a confidence issue? Because women can detect insecurity a mile away, Kyle.
And you detect it?
No. I'm married. My radar's been dismantled. Look, women want an alpha male, you know? You gotta exude confidence.
Confidence?
Yeah.
All right.
Can't be that hard, Kyle. I mean, you used to date girls.
Look, it's been a long time, all right? I used to be a fun guy. Used to have fun, but then the alien invasion happened, and my social life started to suck.
Yeah.
Did you find the next clue in there, or what?
No. I think your whole falafel hut theory was a little off. Yeah. Come on, let's go.
Where are we going?
Find you a new social life. Drop the jerky. Collection for a new keg?
Why don't I check and see if the keg is really empty first?
You're out of beer?
Hey, maybe I can help.
Townie?
Seriously, I have a way with this thing.
Do my guess, please.
Sometimes it's this, this thing up here.
What?
I'm sure it's... I don't know. Give that a shot.
Oh! Oh, man!
There was nothing in there. That was it?
Apparently not.
Dude, it's all dirty!
Good. Listen, I'm looking for a party.
Party right here, baby.
You guys know any clues for Enigma? Hey. Oh.
Where's the cake?
Okay, this is so not the right place. Bozos. No one's ever heard of Enigma. I even let Dave Lambert touch my ass.
Did Michael see that?
The chaperone speaks. I don't know. And it doesn't matter, because we're not together.
Where is one?
Because I need some breathing room. Baby, pull your chucks is what I say. The consequence is what you'll pay. Behind my back, you play your tricks. You know that.
Hey, okay. Sorry, I only have eyes for Maria, but she's handed her blood out to total strangers. What's that about?
Michael, what are you doing? I told you it happened the one and only time I got drunk. My powers were crazy.
I'm fine. I got no power problems whatsoever.
All right. What are you saying, that car will go? What's the matter?
It's a killer grip.
Oh, it's loud right now.
Yeah. Can you walk?
It's bright. It's really bright. Right, Max, what's on me? Max, what's on my back?
Your shirt.
No, Max. I got some... Max, I'm on fire! I'm on fire! Max, I'm on fire! I'm on fire! I'm on fire!
Michael, let's go.
Max, I'm on fire!
He's drunk?
Too loud.
Yeah.
So wait a minute. My New Year's Eve isn't being ruined by some life-threatening hot flash alien disease. It's because Michael's drunk?
I think the alcohol affected his senses. Some sort of sensory overload. Things too bright, too loud.
So I guess the search for Enigma's over.
No, it's still early. You could just...
What's that stench? Is that you?
I don't have a stench.
Might be your perfume.
It smells like roadkill.
It's $50 an ounce, man.
That stuff stinks.
You know, you're an ass, man. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Quick, get in the car.
All right, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. And the first ball out is Spaceship 17. Mark that one if you caught it. Spaceship 17. Spaceship
17. Seems to be having a good time.
Yep. Go figure. An hour ago,
yeah?
You would have thought she'd been sentenced to work here tonight. Tim, can I ask you something?
Sure.
What do you think about Max Evans?
Honestly? I think a great deal of him. I think he's a very special kid.
I used to think so, too. He always seemed like a responsible, straight-ahead kid.
Listen, this is a tough age. I mean, take it from a father of a teenage boy. They up and do things that... Jeff, I can't honestly sit here and give you the boys will be boys routine. Max screwed up big time. Put your daughter in danger. There's no excuse for that. Since you seem to be asking my opinion, I think Max is a good kid who made a big mistake. I truly believe that he's learned from it. And I think he really does love your daughter and deserves a second chance.
Michael's up, very up. Come here. Oh, his senses are super, super bright. So, if the lights are too bright or if he hears anything really loud, it really, really hurts.
Let you whisper, just do it right now.
College party at a frat house. Why am I here?
Because you need to set your sights a little higher than high school.
But I am in high school.
Yes, but they don't know that.
That's true.
Yeah. Okay, so pick one.
Ooh, how about her? How about her?
Okay. That's Sally Reynolds. She's in my philosophy class. Not your type. She's a nihilist. Would never get yourself something to work.
How about those two brunettes over there?
Okay, that one right there is Kim Langstrom. She's actually really very nice, but she's got a laugh like breaking glass. The other one, Bernadette Tahoe. Okay. Yeah, she's dumb as a fence post and only likes girls.
Well, there's gotta be someone.
Oh, you see that girl right there talking to the jock and knows that everything he's telling her is total crap?
Yeah, yeah.
That's Bitsy.
Bitsy?
Yeah, I know, she's got a stupid name. Trust me, Kyle, she's the girl of your dreams. Oh. Yeah, break your glass. Okay, let's go meet her. Okay. Now just be cool. Bitsy, how about you meet a friend of mine? Kyle.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you.
Is he gonna live?
I think he's past the rough stuff. You should leave me for a few minutes. notice if I duck in the bathroom?
Go for it. My dad's not calling Bingo.
Hey, for the big money?
What a great New Year's Eve.
I know. Do you have any luck finding Enigma?
No.
Well, you still have plenty of time. But what's the point? My evening's set. I mean, I'm just gonna be stuck here babysitting a drunken alien.
You know, you didn't mean to ruin everything.
I know. And anyway, it's my fault for inviting him, but it's just like, we keep doing this dance. It's like we're dating, we're together, we're not together, but if we're together, nothing ever changes.
Where's that darn van?
Maybe you don't really want anything to change. Maybe. Or maybe neither one of us is strong enough or crazy enough to break the cycle. Is my life really gonna be like this from now on? I mean, no matter what I do or say, I just somehow get roped back into an alien crisis? I can't even get one night off to find a stupid party.
And then the quarterback said, throw me the chicken, and I did.
He's hilarious. I told you he's hilarious. No, but really, Kyle, you've changed since then. Kyle's a Buddhist now. It's really inspirational.
You want to talk religion?
Okay, but tell me you're not just some guy with a fat Buddha statue. Pray see it late on Friday night.
No, I do have a statue, I do. And I do pray on Friday night sometimes, yes.
And you're honest.
I try.
You succeed.
Is that good?
Very.
Okay, I'm gonna go get some drinks. You guys want anything?
I'm okay.
Me too.
Okay, be back whenever.
Hey, wait.
I just want to say thanks for, you know.
My pleasure.
Yeah, she is. I'm gonna head back to the school for a second.
Why?
Something about that clue in the board keeps bugging me.
Max, would you drop the act already?
It's not an act.
Liz, it's almost 10:30.
Sorry, Dad. I'll be right there.
Hey, Max?
Yeah?
Where are you going?
What kind of boyfriend isn't with his girl at midnight? Don't you have any class? Tick tock.
Oh.
Come on, Max. Let's get a move on. I gotta make a phone call at midnight, and I'm gonna be late.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, hurry it, fine. You don't have to do that.
What's the point? I'm stuck here anyway, so.
Hey, Maria.
What are you doing up? You shouldn't be up.
Can I talk to you in the back for a minute? Lizzie. That's good enough. I can finish up.
What are you talking about? The place is a mess.
That's okay. I can take care of it. Why don't you, why don't you two go out and have a real New Year's?
Dad.
Well, I put a resolution on the cactus, and it said, give second chances. I'm fine, all right. I want you to get back out there and find Enigma.
Where is this coming from? You're being way too self-sacrificing.
I want you to have a night off from all this alien crap. You know, we keep doing this dance and...
You heard me and Liz from all the way up there?
Maria, you were right. Someone's got to break the cycle. We're not together. That's fine. We're still friends, and friends can go their separate ways to have a good time on New Year's Eve. I want you to go out there and find Enigma.
You see, the thing is, I also put a resolution on the cactus. It said, remember that your parents won't always be there.
So you want to stay?
Well, yeah, it's Crash on New Year's. It's like this family tradition. I think my dad deserves one night a year. I'm sorry. I know we promised that we'd be together at midnight.
We were. We crashed out at midnight.
Yeah, I guess that counts.
Listen, I'll stay too. Yeah, help you clean up.
You really want to go to Enigma, don't you?
Well.
God, look at you.
Yeah, I just want to go by myself.
Who still wants to find a party?
Oh, I think that might be this guy right here.
Oh, Max, the chaperone thing, really. It's getting old, and it's just completely unnecessary by now.
All right, that's it. I'm going to that party. Wish me luck.
Good luck.
Let's go. Party train is leaving.
Is he serious?
Very. Oh, wait, what happened with Michael?
Oh, he gave me the night off.
Good for you. Mm-hmm. Is he okay?
Yeah, he's fine. I can't believe I'm going to Enigma. You don't mind.
No, rent my boyfriend for the evening? Go ahead.
Okay, bye. Thanks, bye.
You sure you're not disappointed?
What are you talking about? I got the girl's phone number.
Yeah, but you wanted to get laid.
Look, I got a college girl's phone number. I'm way ahead of the game. And you gotta know when to hold them and...
When to fold them.
Know when to walk away.
Know when to run.
Hey, thanks. I had a really good time.
Yeah, me too. But you know, the night is not over yet.
It's not?
No. It's over an hour till midnight.
Okay, well, then what do you want to do?
How much do you love me?
Oh. Rudolph Shiny New Year?
Please.
Oh, the sacrifices I make for my friends.
Thank you. The best.
Don't be a complete idiot.
So all we know for sure is that 7 does not stand for Dave Lambert's jersey number.
02470.
What if it's a math puzzle? I mean, if we assume that the zeros are placeholders for integers, that...
Ooh! 24-7. It's so simple. It's painful.
Feels like the right place.
Hey, have you found any clues?
No, not yet. Hey, is that Max Evans?
Yeah. Dara, right?
Yeah. So what are you doing, man?
What do you mean?
I mean, out, at night, on New Year's Eve?
I'm looking for a party.
Right.
I think I found one of the clues, but I don't know what it means.
Where?
It's right behind me.
A flyer?
It's not a real flyer.
So one of these specials must be the clue.
Blue Moon Quesadilla, there's no such thing, but what does that mean?
Blue Moon Quesadilla. Blue Moon... Blue Moon Canyon.
That's it! Walk back to the car, nice and easy, like we haven't found a thing. He just drained too much.
Well, let's get him upstairs.
Yeah, just put him in my bed and I'll sleep down here.
Oh, my head.
Should have seen him standing there all brave and noble. It's enough to make you fall in love with him all over again.
Yeah, well, I have to live with him. That's enough.
Are you sure we're on Juarez Road?
Positive.
Then where's the turnout to Blue Moon Canyon?
About 3 or 4 miles.
Seconds till midnight.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, Isabel.
So, are you ready?
I've been thinking about this my whole life. I'm so ready.
Thank you.
What, that you slept in my bed? No, come on, it's a promise not to tell Max.
Yeah.
Hi!
Hey! Jesse, hey, how's Houston?
Cold and uncomfortable. Spent the night in the airport.
What? You're kidding.
Yeah, I wish I was. New Year's Eve all alone, and then I come home to find my wife asleep with another man.
What?
Morality has no place on New Year's Eve. I saw an opportunity, and I took it.
Lesson is, never leave me alone. Ever.
Lesson learned. So I assume nobody found that enigma thing, right?
I wouldn't be too sure of that.
So alive, for the very first time, and I can't
deny it. How's it go?
Oh, yes, we found it, closed it, did it.
That's unbelievable.
Tell us everything.
Okay, well, first we go all the way back to the classroom for clues.
It was at the falafel hut, right?
The what?
Let her tell the story.
Thank you, Michael. Anyway, as I was saying, hi.
The kitchen is open. Orders?
Oatmeal.
Egg and a whole.
Fresh egg real.
I like oatmeal.
Okay, I like fresh egg.